kind of like seeing the president here on the broadcast tonight. There is Briscoe McPherson, as he is here as the head coach in his 11th season at USAO, making it to the title game in the second appearance for this program. So they have known nothing except making it to the title game. Last season they lost to Faulkner. Tonight they hope to win over their conference foe, Oklahoma Baptist. And we throw it down to the PA announcer for some pregame festivities here.
Number 4, Justin Roy. Number 10, Kyle Tolan. Number 14, Josh Wells. Number 15, Richard Spears. Number 20, Adam Hawkins. Number 22, Corey Kiebert. Number 23, David Walkingstick. Number 24, Stephen Smith. And number 45, Jared Johnson. And now, tonight's starting lineups. For the Trovers, a 6'4" junior from Garland, Texas, number 10, Corey Wicker. For the Bison, a 5'11" junior from New Orleans, Louisiana, number 3, David Williams. For the Trovers, a 6-foot junior from Fletcher, Oklahoma, number 20, Hayden Heron. For the Bison, a 6'3" junior from Norman, Oklahoma, number 11, Nate Boylan. For the Trovers, a 6'2" junior from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, number 30, Michael Williamson. For the Bison, a 5'10" senior from Decorah, Iowa, number 12, Patrick Salim. For the Trovers, a 6'4" senior from Irving, Texas, Theron Jackson. For the Bison, a 6'7" junior from Edmond, Oklahoma, number 25, Scott Prater. And for the Trovers, a 6'10" senior from Stillmore, Georgia, number 44, Randy Hughes. For the Bison, a 6'6" senior from Detroit, Michigan, number 44, Duan Brown.
There is the head man for Oklahoma Baptist in his second season, Doug Tolan. Over 80% of the games he has won as the head coach here. A great coach at the high school level at Norman, Ada, and Bartlesville. And let's take a look at these starting lineups once again. We will recap those for you. Starting lineups brought to you by Broom Oldsmobile, where trust begins. Again, Duan Brown, player of the year in the Sooner Athletic Conference, averaging over 29 a game in this tournament. Prater is excellent inside, 17 points, almost 9 rebounds a game. David Williams, who suffered the concussion earlier in the week. Nate Boylan and Patrick Salee in the backcourt. For Science and Arts, Corey Wicker had 20 last night. Randy Hughes had 26. Theron Jackson is a very steady player for this team, averaging 12 a game on the season. Williamson is the All-American first team. And Hayden Heron, the guy that hit 24 points last night, 8 three-pointers to win it in overtime over Barrett. There is Randy Hughes, who had the double-double last night, and he'll go up in the center circle against Duan Brown.
Very difficult to beat a team three straight times during the course of the season already. OBU 2-0 in this matchup, as we discussed. Obviously, some matchup problems all around the court for both teams.
Here we go for the national championship in the NAIA Division I tournament.
Interesting matchup on the inside. Theron Jackson, probably the best all-around player for the Trovers, is guarding the NAIA season scoring leader, Duan Brown.
Stolen out front by Heron on the deck ahead of the pack. The streak Hughes! And we are up to a start with a bang.
That's how it happens. Randy Hughes runs the floor so well. He puts so much pressure on the opposition's big man, in this case, Prater.
There goes Boylan. Shot was bothered by Hughes as he's everywhere here in the first minute. And out of bounds to OBU. I would like to have Randy Hughes at 6'10", I think, anchoring my mile relay team. Look at the wheels.
No question. Excellent job getting off in the defensive end. And then Hughes wrecking rims right off the bat.
OBU on the board, and scoring that one is Williams as he gets them off to a start, and we are tied at 2.
Down low, Hughes spinning in the lane, missing the shot, Brown the rebound. So they go right to work with Hughes out of the gate.
Exactly what happened last night. Randy Hughes got off to a bang, had 10 points early on in that battle.
Salee dumping it to Prater. Back to Salee, into the lane, on the pull-up, the high arcing shot, rebounded by Heron. And quickly, here come the Drovers. On the baseline, Jackson. Here's Wicker. Heron for three. And he picks up where he left off last night.
String music.
So Hayden Heron, who hit 8 threes last night for 24, starts off the game, nothing but the bottom on his first three. Salee missing. Hughes the rebound.
Look at Randy Hughes run. Prater's trying to catch up with him. Watch that matchup all night.
Williamson, a hot step, and I'll see you with the left hand.
The advantage right there. Michael Williamson at 6'2 is being guarded by another honorable mention All-American, David Williams at 5'11.
Oklahoma Baptist, this is the sixth time as Prater scores inside on a nice look from Salee.
Pick to free Prater inside.
For the sixth time in their history, they're playing in the championship game. Jackson is fouled as he takes it in. Oklahoma Baptist won it back in 1966 behind their star, the late Al Tucker, who averaged over 30 points a game for his career in this tournament. And USAO, in their first appearance last season, went to the title game before falling to Faulkner. And tonight, they make it to the final game again. So Briscoe McPherson has a record in this tournament as a coach of 8-1.
Goes Theron Jackson, probably their best all-around player. Theron Jackson obviously draws the assignment of the best offensive player from the other team that had 8 points, 8 rebounds, and 5 assists in last night's semifinal game.
Here's Prater backing it in. Out high, Boylan. And Prater worked a two-man game. Boylan for three. Rebound taken out of the air by Jackson. He looks to run with it.
Oh,
on the wing, Heron, not again. He's just burying these threes as it's his personal last couple of nights here. And timeout call. The baseball player, Hayden Heron, drills his first two threes after 8 last night.
Well, both threes, he's had nobody within at least 5 to 7 feet of. Hayden Heron in transition, and Hayden Heron has nobody at all close to him. He's going to drain those. He was 8 for 12 last night behind the arc, and wide open, he's going to probably nail a higher percentage than that.
I got to go back to last night when his dad in that nice Oklahoma, Fletcher, Oklahoma accent said, I just need to get Hayden to shoot the rock. And, of course, Hayden came on out and drilled 4 after that. Helped his team win the ball game, and he has got his team started very well tonight early with 2 straight threes, and it's 11-4 USAO on top. Doug, let's not forget, Oklahoma Baptist has beaten USAO twice this season. Last time out, they won by 40 at Shawnee, where Oklahoma Baptist is located. So that has to weigh on the minds of both these teams.
No question, there's no question. Both teams are familiar with each other. And USAO obviously coming out early for revenge.
The battle of the Sooner State. It's just like the championship game of the Sooner Athletic Conference. But how about the other teams in that conference? Oklahoma City was here. Wayland Baptist was here in the national tournament. They both play in the Sooner Athletic Conference. Oklahoma Christian is very good. Between his legs, and somehow Williamson caught the pass. We're going with the between the legs backward pass here at the title game of the national tournament. Williamson, Jackson on the baseline. Hughes the rebound. Randy Hughes last night all over the boards with 15 rebounds to go along with 26 points.
Oh,
off the glass and through there for Randy Hughes.
Good job by Hughes. Hughes for the season is a 52% field goal shooter. A lot of easy shots in transition, but has the ability to post up.
Largest lead of the game of 9. Boylan got his own right back at him. Brown tips it up, and he's on the scoreboard.
Best way for a scorer to get going is to get inside, grab a rebound, and put it up. Exactly what Brown just did.
Heron out high working against Salee.
Out high, Heron. On the drive. Back to Jackson. Shot clock now at a dozen. Inside, Hughes missed the shot. And the rebound taken away by Prater.
Good look by Theron Jackson.
Soleil off to Boylan, working against Wicker. Remember, Nate Boylan has cousins, Micah Boylan and Lamar Boylan from the other team, and they both meet here in the championship game. Ahead of the pack, and in the crack it goes by Jackson, but he's fouled as he takes it in. So no signs of fatigue early on, Doug, for USAO. You might have thought they'd come out a little tired after playing overtime last night in that track meet.
Good job by Theron Jackson to get things going with his defense and then force the issue as he saw he had the advantage on the defensive end that time going against Patrick Sally.
And Jackson misses the first. He'll have another one coming into the ball game for Oklahoma Baptist. This is Kyle Tolan, and he checks in. 5'10", 155 sophomore from Norman, Oklahoma, as Jackson drops the second one through, and we have timeout on the floor. 15-16 left here in the first half. So far, it's USAO by 8.
Nothing but net. I rip cores like skydivers. My offense explodes, defenses tripwire. Got CO2? Your squad's on fire. Ignited by 10 fingers, 10 panels united. Form of more grooves, more grip, more game. I'm running this. Save the cream and fame. I got love for this. My internal eternity flame, a 10-panel lyricist. The 40's my stage. My asphalt flow intricate, my 10-panel advantages infinite. Rawlings, 10 panels. More grooves, more grip, more game.
Welcome back to the Municipal Auditorium in Kansas City. USAO leads it by 8. Let's go to Kevin White. Kevin?
All right, thanks, Neil. I got Michael Williamson's mom here, Tina. And mom, a very special day. Your son, an All-American. I told you the news, and boy, that smile, it might be a little bit bigger when you heard the news. You got to be proud.
Right, I'm very proud of him. He's worked hard to get there.
What about this ball game thus far? Your team off to a nice start, huh?
Yeah, they're going to win this tonight. They're
going to
win.
Well, go enjoy the game. Thanks for your time. Back to you guys, Neil.
Thank you, Kevin. She should be proud. First team All-American for Mike Williamson this season. And while we were talking to mom, David Williams buried one from outside, and Williams with his first three tonight. Remember, he had 20 last night in that game over Azusa Pacific. Heron on a fadeaway. Are you kidding me? He just continues to bury the three.
3 of 3 already, 9 points in the first 4.5 minutes of this game. 5.5 minutes.
Juan Brown with the left, goes right back up and is fouled. The left-hander taking it in strong that time, as he has scored 2 points here tonight, averaging over 29 a game in the tournament. And we look again at the senior.
This is the advantage right now of Brown. He's got the ability to post up on the inside as he's got Theron Jackson with not as much weight and height as Brown, but then he can take a big guy outside and utilize his quickness and versatility.
Talk about first-team All-Americans. Juan Brown made it again. Perhaps he could be the player of the year. I didn't see if they announced a player of the year, but certainly he would be a candidate. On the move, Jackson. Lost the handle. Coming out of there is Williams. David Williams, the 5'11 junior from New Orleans, tries the three. Oh, mercy! Right in the face of the defense.
He is the answer right now to Hayden Harris.
Jackson from outside, and the rebound, Crater. So that three by Williams cuts the lead to three for USAO.
Sophomore Kyle Tolan, coach's son, also a capable scorer. 3 of 3 outside of the arc from the three-point line to quarterfinals, and 9 attempts from the foul line in the summer.
Williams on the pull-up, please! Williams in a heartbeat has 10 points now.
So quick, and a very quick release as well.
The lead is one for the Drovers of USAO. Here's Williams' son, taking it to the baseline, back out high to Jackson.
Doing a good job focusing on Williamson. David Williams doing an excellent job on the ball, but he's got help behind him.
Here's Wicker for three. Bateman, who just checked in, grabbed the rebound, but Prater, who's been working out in Gold's Gym this year, just took it right away. And look at that guy, a solidly built 225, 6'7", Scott Prater, the junior from Edmond. Tolan right down central!
You gotta respect his three, and that gave Tolan the ability to drive back.
Oklahoma Baptist takes a one-point lead and timeout on the floor. We look again at the 5'10", 155 sophomore on the penetration.
We got to respect Kyle Tolan outside. He uses a pump fake. Good job by the coach's son. And then getting in the teeth of the defense with the easy layup. Excellent job with the pump fake. Gets Hayden Herring to bite on it because he is such a good outside shooter and a nice floating shot.
So Tolan.